the first one on my list is HBO's new miniseries, Chernobyl.
Not new. It's been a while since we recorded. Some of the, like, I watched a lot of these a while ago.
That is true. I mean, I did watch Chernobyl a while ago. But I thought I spoke about it on the last episode, and I was like, I didn't talk about Chernobyl, because this is my favorite thing I've, like, ever seen.
This ever?
Honestly, it's so fucking good. It is, I just feel like it's the definition of a masterpiece. Like, it's a slow burn, but it's never boring. It's always, like, if this was a movie, if I saw this in a movie theater, I'd be on the edge of my seat for the entire, like, 6 hours. It's so good. And each episode, I'm like, okay, this has to be the best episode. But somehow they keep doing, like, one-upping it until they get to the final episode where it's, like, one of my favorite episodes of anything ever. The only thing that really is, like, comparative to it. Not in, like, what they're trying to do, but, like, in, like, a level of quality of an episode.
Yeah, the
is,
episode like, Ozymandias of,
is, and that episode of True Detective Season 1 with the single shot. It's just so, that,
well, that and the episode of Jimmy Neutron where he's working at the shop and somebody's like, no. Do you want salt? And he's like, don't you mean, do you mean sodium chloride?
Jimmy Neutron's on Hulu if you want to go watch it. But Chernobyl, for those of you who don't know,
No, it's almost as good as the episode where Jimmy Neutron and Timmy Turner crossed over into each other's world, and you got the ugliest Timmy Turner I've ever seen in my whole goddamn life, and he was horrifying.
I know what you're talking about. That was a strange one. But this one is all about the nuclear power plant, Chernobyl.
And which actually caused everyone to look like Timmy Turner in the Jimmy Neutron universe.
I hate
it. It was that bad. Are you telling me a nuclear disaster can't be the only reason that we got that Timmy Turner?
Yes. It's just so good. And there are so many things. Like, I thought I knew pretty much, like, the gist of Chernobyl, but this, like, opened my eyes to so many, like, what in a history textbook would be, like, a single sentence, but when it's played out, it's just like, oh my god. Like, it's amazing. It's, like, ugh! There's this one part in, like, the second to last episode, I think, that has to do with dogs and, like, animals, and it's just, it's the craziest thing.
That sounds like ever. A lot to deal with emotionally.
I told my dad to watch this, and he watched it twice, both in one day. So, it's super good. Go watch this. If you have HBO, you have to watch this. Like, the first 5 minutes, I understand if you think the first 5 minutes is boring, but I promise you, right after that, it picks up. Because I started this, and I was like, you know what? This looks a little too slow for me. Gonna push it off until later. I know I probably have to watch it because it's, like, getting, like, blown up and how good it is. But I didn't know how good it really was. And now I'm, like, the number one, like, pusher of Chernobyl on people. I'm like,
number one.
This. Number one.
What a potentially scathing, excessively positive, or exceedingly middling review of that movie you just heard. If you want to hear more that could potentially fit into any of those categories, click this box, which has more reviews and clips from the main show. We also got our weekly mini episodes over here in this box.
And make sure to click the circle in the middle to subscribe to the channel so you never miss out on another episode in the future.